Lesson 4, the locker room view. The game of basketball is played at many speeds. Each game is affected by a variety of factors, including coaching philosophy, referee calls, and player personnel. As a player, I would try to figure out the pace of the game before I played it. In high school, most teams were known for playing a certain way. In college, you get to study your opponent's game film before you compete. These all give advantages to the scorer because you want to have a visual of where your points are going to come from each game. If you know you're playing a fast-paced team that likes to run up and down the floor, then most of your points are going to come in transition. If the team is known for slowing the game down, then you know that a lot of your points or opportunities are going to come through half-court sets. Do your homework so you can pass the test. Having these forecasts in place allows you to visualize what's going to happen when you hit the court. This is one of the less talked about aspects of becoming a great scorer. My mother used to say that in order to be it, you have to see it. Before any game, you have to visualize yourself in different scoring positions. Layups, 15-foot jump shots, dribble drives to the basket. Play them all in your head over and over again. Visualization is power. It allows your mind and body to get ready for what you're going to do on the court. I can remember going on trips for away games and watching my teammates crack jokes and cut up in the locker room. I always would say to myself, how do you expect to perform at a high level if you're not visualizing the task at hand? I would always say to myself, how do you expect to perform at a high level if you're not visualizing the task at hand? The problem is a lot of players do not understand the concept of visualization. They just go out and see what happens. That may work for some, but I tell you now, if you don't have a plan in place, you're setting yourself up for inconsistent results. When you are in the locker room, you want to get into your zone. Whatever you have to do to focus on your game is up to you. During the 90s, I had a Walkman, and I know some of you are saying, "Hey, coach, you're getting pretty old." Yeah, now we have iTunes. But before, we had Walkmans, and I used this to get myself into a certain zone and state. Most of my teammates knew not to talk around me during game times because I wouldn't talk back. I was in a zone, and unless the building was on fire, I didn't want to hear anything. If there was an example of how you should conduct yourself before a game, it would be observing Kevin Garnett. I love the fact that even though he makes millions of dollars, he still takes the time to separate himself from his surroundings and visualize the game at hand. A few minutes before the game, Garnett goes into this zone that is second to none. It's almost scary. With that kind of mindset, he's poised to perform every night, and the fans always get their money's worth, which is why they called him the big ticket. Coach Godwin tips for lesson number 4, the locker room view. Separate from your surroundings so you can visualize. Tune everything out. Just make sure you're focused. I know most of the time we have, you know, players that we're close to on the team, and you may like to cut up after practice or crack jokes, but it's not the time. If you really want that scholarship, if you really want that opportunity to play at the next level, whether it be overseas in the NBA, you have to be able to tune people out, even the crowd. Always visualize positive results. Dunks, layups, steals, three-point shots, transition. You have to see that in your mind. Play it over and over again. I know there are certain plays where I used to come off screens. I would visualize that play and me knocking down that jump shot. Try to see where your points are going to come from. The paint, transition, half-court sets, etc. Only you know, through practice and your teammates. And that's why you really have to get to know your teammates, because there are certain things that come during the game that are ad hoc, whether it be a backdoor cut or a slip of a screen. Those are the things that are cultivated during practice that allow you to see where your points are going to come from. Do your homework about the team you're playing so you know what to visualize. Don't get caught up in your numbers or your last performance. Every game is different. Some teams like to play slow, which will be a half-court game. Other teams like to trap and run. Just do your homework and know what type of situation or game you're going to play that day.